Hello, my name is Dr. Colt Knight. I am an associate extension professor and state livestock specialist for the University of Maine. And today I thought I'd talk about a topic that's pretty near and dear to my heart because I'm also a farm owner and operator. And with the rising cost of materials and the difficulty of terrain and weather here in Maine, I thought I would present an alternative fencing method I've been researching lately. Now, the foundation of any good fence are your corner braces and end of line braces for your fence post or terminal ends of your fence. And some of the best corner brace systems are these H braces, where you sink the post deep into the ground, make sure that they are either tamped or concreted in. They have a horizontal brace, and they have tie wire to keep all the forces together and prevent the fence from tearing itself apart. Now, when I make these H braces, it takes 5 good quality posts, 6 bags of concrete, and I have to drill 3 holes 4 foot deep to keep the frost from pushing them out in the spring. And that's expensive and labor intensive. When I first moved to Maine, I did not understand frost heave and the impacts it has on fence posts. So as you can see, my first attempt at a fence turned out extremely poorly. Every winter, when the ground thaws out, these posts lift up out of the ground and they tilt willy-nilly every which direction. After learning my lesson from that little pig fence I built firsthand, my second attempt at fence, I went with a much more sturdy design using traditional H braces, thick cedar post concreted deep into the ground. And as you can see, they've remained straight over the last couple winters. Now, don't get me wrong, I did get a little lazy. Every so many posts, I would hit a nice big rock that wasn't easily dislodged from the hole, so not all the posts are 4 foot deep. This gate post, where I latch my gate, I only got it about 2.5 feet deep because I just hit this big monster rock, and the rock bar wasn't breaking it out. And as you can see, every winter, or spring I should say, the frost pushes this post another inch or two out of the ground and it gets a little loose. And because of that, I have to reset my gate latch every spring, which is a real pain. And here's another example of one I didn't quite get in the ground as deep as I'd like. And let me tell you, that concrete really tears up the mower deck. Now, I like to cheap out like everyone else, and so I was started to cut my own cedar post off of the woods in my property. And one of the decisions you have to make is, do you skin the bark off or leave it on? So let's talk about why you should take it off. This was a really steep slope, so I built a nice level walkway for my wife's dog kennels. This cedar tree was cut at the same time as the other cedar tree, but I skinned this one. And when we look all the way around the post, we have good structural integrity, no rot, and no soft spots. But let's take a look at this one where I left the bark on. And you can clearly see over the years, moisture collects in behind the bark and bugs and microorganisms get in here and eat out the wood and actually leave soft spots, which greatly reduces the life of the post. When I visited the National Farm Machinery Show in Louisville, there was a booth there promoting a T-post only corner brace and line post fencing solution. And while I am pretty skeptical of claims, I thought it looked like a possible solution for here in Maine. So this corner brace solution uses 5 T-posts and a corner brace kit constructed out of plastic. There are also some metal bracket solutions on the market, but what intrigued me about this one is when I string this up with electric wire, the hot wires actually come over and touch the diagonal brace, which is insulated from the ground using the plastic brackets, therefore rendering the diagonal braces a hot wire, and it keeps the livestock from pushing into the substantially weaker corner braces. Now, they have a lot of strength when you push them this way, because that's the way that the braces work. But the other direction, they don't have much strength at all. So I really like this. The other thing that I like about this solution is it has a ratcheting adjustment. So if the ground settles or big tree falls on, or the livestock do something to the fence, I have the ability to adjust the tension quite a bit by simply pushing down and out on the corner. This row of fence has 10 posts in it. Now, that would take me all day to dig those holes, set concrete, and make sure that they're all level with the amount of rock that I have to deal with. Now, the company that fabricates the corner braces also sells these heavy-duty fence insulators, which easily clip onto a T-post in 6 different directions, so the T-post doesn't have to be facing the same direction. My biggest concern with this fencing system was, what do I do about the gate? Am I going to have to sink in at least a handful of wooden posts to support the weight of the gate? And as it turns out, no, I didn't have to do that. I got online and I found these inexpensive T-post gate hangers. A secondary concern of mine was whether these T-post systems could support the tension of a high tensile electric fence. And what I found was, you could set the tensioning springs to the full tension, which is about 250 foot-pounds on this particular set, and the corner braces would work just fine, but the plastic insulators would start to fail at that much tension. But if I backed these off to the low setting of between 100 and 150 foot-pounds, the whole fence system worked just fine, and there is plenty of tension on this fence. So what about the negatives of this fence system? Like I said, it won't hold the full tension of a high tensile fence, so you have to use the low setting. The equipment is not available at the local hardware store or feed store like your traditional fencing supplies, so you have to order it online. And because of that, it would probably be a good idea to order extras in case anything breaks. You'll be able to fix it right away instead of having to wait for the new parts to be shipped in. I've noticed this new system is quite popular, so the corner brace kits do go out of stock frequently. So it's always good to have extra in case you need to replace or repair anything. But all in all, this fence system saved me a ton of time, labor, and expense. And I can break that down for you. I'm going to open Google Earth Pro, find my farm, select the ruler polygon tool to set the perimeter and acreage of my fence so that I know how many materials to order.
looks like I'm going to need 44 posts, about 2,500 feet of high tensile electric fence, a gate, the gate hardware, and all the hardware you need to attach the fence to the posts. Now I'm going to look at how much it would cost me to buy the unique T-post system versus buying a conventional wood fence. And I need to look at the items that I'd have to buy regardless of which fence system I'd use. And when I look at the T-post system versus what I would have spent on building a conventional wood post system, there is some substantial savings there, in the order of $582.37. While everyone's situation is different, I highly encourage you to look into different fencing solutions to see if you can save some time and money. This project was brought to you by the University of Maine Cooperative Extension Grazing Behavior Lab and the Maine New Farmers Project. And a thank you to Knight Family Farm for allowing us to use their facilities.